Hello and welcome back to the PopcornFX channel. In this tutorial, we'll be explaining how ribbon works. As you can see, I changed the interface because I think it provides a favorable user experience. Try it out, and if you don't like it, just go to layout, click on load to restore the default layout configuration. Alright, let's get the ribbons started. We'll create a new layer, press Ctrl R since the loop particle system in the editor is turned off, and check out the lovely replace me particles. Now we'll click on the renderer and create the particle ribbon renderer. And delete the billboard renderer by pressing delete. Alright, now we'll go to the spawner script and comment out the velocity since we don't need the particles to move on their own. We want this to be more of a trail, so the system has to move in order for the sword slash to appear. And now every time we need to see the trail, we'll have to move the spawner, but another method would be to use the animation path. So we'll go to the editor properties and choose an anim clip. And we'll go for the anim circle. And make sure that is animated and transform rotate are checked. Press Ctrl R, so now the particles follow the animation path. I'll turn on the loop particle system so that it would automatically repeat every time it's over. I'm going to turn off the grid for a better visual. There we go. Notice that the trail feels a little bit low resolution, and that's normal, and that's due to the lack of particles present in that layer. So if we were to increase the number of particles, it'll add more definition to the trail. It's looking good. And here are the particles in shaded plus wireframe mode. You can see the number of particles. And when you drop the number, you can see a huge difference. Alright, let's go back to the shaded mode and choose the texture. We'll click on the ribbon and go look for the boom renderer. And after that, we're gonna pick the atlas that goes with it. Alright, so what's going on now is that the texture ID 0 is being used on every particle. But we want the texture to be stretched along the whole particle layer, and make it have a really nice smooth slash. To do so, we need the texture U field. The texture U field divides the texture and expands it on the whole layer, and the best way to do so is to put the life ratio in the texture U field. I still haven't pressed enter yet. Wait for it. Oh, we just need to rotate the texture, and it's legendary! You can see a small problem though on the sides, and that's because the size of the ribbon is way too big. Luckily, there are two ways to fix it. That's either by reducing the size of the ribbon or actually dividing the ribbon and making multiple layers, so that the ribbon particles won't intersect. We're going to change the size over time of the ribbon by using sizeCoeth. We're going to change it in the Volvo script, so I'm going to add it right now. Then change the size to sizeCoeth, and we'll add it to the field since it's the only way to pass the variable to the Volvo script to change it over time. We'll press Ctrl Enter and the trail is going to disappear because the size in the Volvo script isn't set yet. So we're going to set it in the Evolver script. So for now, we'll go for size equals size coef. And finally, we'll add a field, put it before the Evolver script because order matters. Choose the size as the field to change. And we'll edit the curve. And the last thing we need to do is to change something in the Evolver script. And that is to multiply the size by the size coef. And what Popcorn is doing is that it's taking the value in the curve depending on the life ratio and multiplying it by the size coef. And now when we change the curve, we're going to see the effect directly changing in the viewport. I'll just adjust the size of the curve. And I'll change the color of the ribbon over the lifetime of the particles. What we do is that we're going to add an evolver field, choose the color, and modify the curve. Click on the dots, then press C to show the color picker. And if you want to add point to the curve without breaking it, we'll Alt-Shift click on the curve. And when you finish the system and you want to try it manually, just go to the editor properties, remove the anim clip, then click on the spawner and move it with the gizmo. Going just to change the trail size. Oh, it's so smooth. And if you want the trail's length to be smaller, you'll just have to reduce the lifetime of the particles. So when we set the lifetime to 0.1, the trail's length will be smaller. Or make it a little bit longer by setting the lifetime to 0.215. Well, this brings us to the end of this tutorial. Give us a like if you find it helpful, and be sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss the part 2 of the trails tutorial. We'll see you then. Thank you for watching.